Hi, Cancers. Welcome to your weekly tarot reading. Let's go into your reading for this month. The first thing that I want to emphasize here is we do have a Mercury in retrograde cycle, and needless to say, whenever Mercury, the planet of communication, is going in the reverse, is retrograding, it basically means that plans are going to be stalled, okay? Things that you're planning on, a specific deadline, specific time frame, specific things going in a specific way, it's going to throw a little bit of a wrench in the works. So anticipate detours, anticipate delays, anticipate things not going exactly the way that you want. It doesn't always mean it's going to be bad. It's just not going to be exactly the way you want, but sometimes it can also be better than what you anticipated or what you could expect, okay? So I feel there are things here, projects, funding for some of you, and plans and overall just, a lot of activities that are going to be a little bit stalled. And I also feel you're gonna feel almost like, a turtle or a crab that's kind of flipped over, where your legs are not able to be firmly planted. You're not able to get your bearing. You're gonna feel a little bit disoriented. There's also a lot of traveling that I'm seeing for many of you. So you're gonna feel that physical and emotional displacement where you're in a different environment, time zone differences, time conversions, as well as misunderstandings when it comes to, cross-cultural communication and things like that. So anticipate these things, and just know to be patient, okay? It's gonna last for the majority of April, and we're also going to be dealing with that shadow period towards the end of April. So just anticipate and just, roll with the punches, be flexible, get things done in a timely manner. Whenever you find downtime, it's a good time for you to switch gears and get things done. Get other projects started, okay? And just basically be flexible. So, what are some of the messages that I am seeing for you guys? The first message that I feel here, it says the trickle-down effects is definitely working, and there are some really good news that is going to be coming through when it comes to your career sector, okay? And what I see happening is this fountain. It's like, you know how they stack up those champagne glasses, and then they stack it up into a pyramid, and whoever, is pouring the champagne bottle, it pours from the first cup, and then it trickles down to all the other cups, and then all the bottom cups get filled up, and then the next rung gets filled up, the next level, and so on and so forth. So I'm seeing this trickle-down effect where things are really benefiting everybody. Things are working out in everybody's favor, and I feel like it's like the desired outcome. Okay, so it's looking really, really good. The second message that I am seeing here is they're saying expansion in birth and finance. So that is coming through in your work sector and also your career sector. So expansion in birth and finance. So that's a really cool message, actually, because I know you guys are have been really, really concerned about your financial prosperity for the past few years, and this is the year where I feel like, hard work is paying off, okay? The third message that I am seeing here is it's almost like being weary, and I don't like to repeat these messages in this way, but I feel like you also need to understand that, there are people that are self-serving. They're gonna do the minimal amount of work to scrape by, and they're gonna ride other people's coattails. Okay? So you wanna be, I wanna say, like, cognizant of that, and you wanna be aware of that. And if you can spot these people, it's really important that you don't let them, reap the material wealth that you've worked really, really, really hard for. So I would say the message here is not to be weary about, opportunists, but like spot them, okay? Spot opportunists. And that message also takes us to the next one, which basically means spot opportunities. Okay, opportunities for you to basically expand outwards, for you to allow things to trickle out further, for you to expand your empire a little bit more. So I have those four messages. Let me just go through them one by one. What I'm feeling for you guys here when it says trickle down, many of you have really taken it upon yourself to really incorporate a lot of people into plans, into projects. You're starting some type of a populist movement. You're riling people up. You're getting people's backing. You're getting people's support. And you're kind of like taking charge in a situation to bring everybody together in some capacity. It could be an event, it could be a talk, it could be like a seminar, a conference, something where many, many people from many, many different parts of the world, or even, you know, from different industries, from different communities, from different walks of life are coming together. And I feel like it's not something that is done overnight. There has been a lot of stalled energy. There has been a lot of hard work, a lot of dedication, a lot of tears shed, a lot of sweat and tears. And finally, it's culminating and it's coming together. And it's coming together in a way where it is definitely a sharing, an exchange of knowledge, a sharing, an exchange of best practices, a sharing and an exchange of different experiences. So it's a really, really wonderful gathering that's happening. And I'm also sensing for many of you, you know, people that say they're supposed to chip in, they're nowhere to be found. And this was particularly difficult for you guys, mainly because I feel for many of you, you are the man or the woman of your words. When you say you're going to do something, you don't want to leave people high and dry. You want to be, you know, seen in a responsible, in a favorable manner. And so when people give you their word, you're like, okay, I've got it, I trust you. And then at the last minute, they don't show up, right? So, what is this about? Like, what is this experience teaching you? It's teaching you to, more than anything, be the man or the woman of your words. It's teaching you what not to do and how not to burn bridges with other people. And it's also teaching you, you know, who those people are. So, those opportunists, those people that just, you know, frivolously give away their word and then they don't stand by their word, or they say they're going to do things and then flake out the last minute and leave people stranded without consideration for you or consideration for all the hard work that comes, that is involved in getting things off the ground. So it's important to, I almost feel like it needed to happen so that you can not partner up with them in the future. So, you know, it's like it needed to happen right now when the project is small. Later on, when the project is bigger and you get involved with them, it's going to be a bigger disappointment, a bigger disaster. Okay. So I am sensing for those of you that have dealt with this back in March, it's done, it's over with, and you know where you stand with people, you know who you shouldn't ally with. For others who are still dealing with this, it's going to happen sometime in April. I do see the 7th and the 17th coming out strongly. And then I'm also sensing as well, you know, you have other people that are going to be there to help you. They're, everything is going to pull together and be a success. Okay, so don't worry about it. But you are going to have these elements in your midst that make promises they can't keep. They're, you know, they're kind of like, oh, I'll do it, and you know, ride the opportunity. They're there to get like the publicity and the visibility, but they don't really, they're not pulling their weight. They're not, you know, contributing their fair share, and you're going to know who they are so that you can avoid them in the future. Okay, so it's coming in as a lesson learned. It needed to happen. It's almost like karmically, it needs to happen so that you can kind of screen them out from your professional contacts in the future and kind of blacklist them. Not that, you're going to hold grudges against them and badmouth them to everybody. You are a very sensitive sign, and I feel like you know how to be courteous. You know how to play office politics. And just out of a sense of human decency, you're not going to call them out on it, embarrass them, or, burn their bridges with other people. You're just not going to allow them to be a professional ally or a professional contact of yours in the future. So it needs to happen, okay? But overall, this trickle-down image, everybody who is there for the right reason, they're benefiting from it. And it's beautiful. It looks really, really amazing. People coming together, sharing ideas, people who are really, really motivated, but also there is a sense of social awareness and social impact. I almost feel like it's a gathering of entrepreneurs who are interested in alleviating, social issues, social problems, who care about other people. So I feel like it's a very, what is that word? Philanthropic, endeavor that everyone is involved in, everyone is on the same page about, and everyone is just, going to benefit from it. So lofty goals, lofty ideals, solidifying and coming together. The second message here, they say an expansion in birth or finance. I feel for some of you, either there's like maternity leave, paternity leave, you or your partner might be taking a leave of absence in the work environment if you are expecting. And then if it's not you, it's your partner. And there's going to be, this sense of like needing to take a break here from the career front in order to conceive or dealing with pregnancy while you're at work, okay? So along with that are the hormonal fluctuations and the changes, okay? But it looks very good. So if you're not dealing with pregnancy, the Empress in your 10th house basically emphasizes a situation where you're expanding your territory, you're expanding your area, your sphere of influence. And I know that phrase, it sounds very, reminiscent of Cold War ideologies, but it came in, and I feel what it basically means overall is allying with other people so that you can, have so that you can have a backer in them, so that you can have their support, so that you can expand your geographical location, you can expand your sphere of influence, okay? For those of you who are in the marketing sector, this is basically looking at new markets, looking at other areas where you can, potentially foster a market, foster an industry. Allowing an industry to grow, or they're saying like fostering or subsidizing an infant industry, and then seeing it grow from the ground up and then benefiting from it long term. So I feel like it's a nurturing process, and it needs to be, done in a very patient manner. It's going to take some time before it bears fruit, but you have the patience and you definitely love to build things from the ground. I feel like for many of you, if you had to choose between coming in from the very, very beginning and building something from scratch and from the ground up, you'd rather do that than coming in the middle when it's already past its infancy stage. So I feel that element coming in where you're going to be designing, starting something from the ground up and seeing it kind of grow, seeing it through its life cycle. I feel for many of you, this might take a few years, 3, 5 years. And after that, so you already anticipate that, okay, this is going to require possibly 3 years of my time. And so, do I have the energy? Can I realistically devote to it right now? And then I also feel for many of you, this is a new job. Like possibly even like a side gig that you're doing, and there is a commitment of your time. Possibly, I'm seeing here three semesters, so it could be like a year and a half even. So that's coming in where you are going to have to decide, like, can I really juggle both of these things? Can I do this, commit myself for a year and a half while maintaining my full-time job? So you have some really beautiful things coming through and you have a lot of opportunities coming through. But the bottom line is, people are coming to you and soliciting you to get involved, to be a partner, to kind of, nurture something and see something grow and to care, like to be the caretaker of something because they trust you. So I'm seeing a very strong reference to France. Okay, so I don't know if this is happening for people that are geographically there, but I do see here France, and I do see as well, let me see, what is the other, for some reason Thailand, those imageries are coming up, those countries in particular are coming up. So projects possibly in France, and I feel like it's a project that involves growing something and fostering an infant industry. So France and Thailand, those areas come up very strongly. Anyways, it looks good. In your career sector, we have here the Ace of Pentacles, and this is usually what I would call like a new job, okay? For many of you who are, and this is like a regular 9-to-5 job where you have a schedule, you're working for another person, it shows that it has a lot of potential, but it seems to me like the salary is a little bit less than what you're expecting. If you are in a position where you're just like, I want to negotiate, definitely negotiate, okay? Don't settle for that first offer. Negotiate your salary. Make sure you are being paid what you're worth. And honestly, your energy is really strong for this month, Cancers. So you really need to negotiate and kind of put yourself out there and ask for more and, you know, not settle for what you, for the crumbs and the scraps that are left behind. So you're in a really good position to let your ideas kind of show and to let your confidence shine, okay? When it comes to communication, we have the Chariot in the reverse, and this is you stalling. This is you feeling that lack of confidence. This is you kind of like, you know, being a little bit timid and humble and not really directing yourself in a, I want to say, they say like concerted manner. So it's almost like your heart and your mind needs to be on the same page, okay? So you can't, for example, if there's a job that's offered and you're just like, okay, I really like the job because, you know, it's perfectly in alignment with what I want to do. And then you look at the salary. So your heart's in it. And then you look at the salary and you're just like, it's paying a little bit less than I'm expecting. So your heart and your mind already are not on the same page. And if you look at it, the only thing that will allow your heart and your mind to be on the same page is if you negotiate for that salary, right? So the only problem is if you already love the job, but your mind is not in it because you're anticipating having to cut corners, having to nickel and dime yourself because the salary is less than you expect, then solve that problem. Negotiate a higher salary. Your heart and your mind needs to be on the same page here with this Chariot in the reverse. It's like inner conflict. It's like dealing with a situation where you're doubting your capabilities and you're like, am I good enough? Can I... It's almost like, do I dare ask for more? Would I be a nuisance to them or would they give me more? And that is really not up for debate for this month. So you need to own up to what you want and you need to demand what you want, okay? You're in a really good position here to make to negotiate. You're really in a good position to demand for what you feel you deserve. So don't shortchange yourself here, Cancers. Relationships. So I have here the Ace of Wands, and the Ace of Wands basically, it's a fire sign. Okay. So this is a Sagittarius, an Aries, or a Leo. And funny thing is, I'm seeing a lot of fire in this spread. The Ace of Wands deals with passion, chemistry, like inspiration. So you are dealing with someone who's very, very inspiring, who's very inspiring to you. You both, you're energetically, I see energies bouncing off each other. There's a lot of attraction because, fire and water is a good combination, right? Like it denotes a lot of attraction. It denotes as well, you're dealing with someone who's really bringing you out of your shell. They're fun, they're adventurous. They want to travel and they're bringing you out of your shell. They're breaking you free from your own am I good enough, self-doubts and that Cancerian shell where you retreat to for comfort and for familiarity. So you're dealing with someone who's very dynamic. And I also feel as well, because of this really strong sense of attraction and opposites attract type of energy, it can also create a situation where you feel a little bit burnt out by this person. It's too much. They're coming on too strong. They want too much. The demands, this person imposes on you is a little bit too much. And that's fine. But it's Mercury in retrograde. So if that happens and you retreat without telling them, hey, I need to take a little bit of a break. I'll be gone for a few days. Don't worry. If you don't communicate that to them, they're gonna think like the worst has happened. They're gonna think like you've got somebody else. They're gonna think like, oh no, why is the Cancer person, retreating? Are they no longer interested in me? Have they found somebody else? Are they cheating on me? Are they lying to me? All of the worst case scenarios. So it's really important to communicate. If you feel burned out, communicate. Okay? Oftentimes, you feel like they should know. You're dealing with a fire sign. Fire signs are not very subtle. They don't really observe the nuances, okay? So they don't, unless you tell them, you're driving me nuts. Give me a break, or back off, or leave me alone. Unless you are very clear and specific about what you want, they're not gonna get it. And you don't have to be mean about it, but you need to communicate and you need to say it in a way where you mean what you say, and you can't be, you can't give them mixed messages. You can't just, say things and sugarcoat and try to spare their feelings. It's not going to work if you're dealing with a fire sign. You need to be very, very direct. So I've seen situations where you guys are, it's like, okay, so example, you have like three people that are interested in you, right? And you're interested in none of them. Rather than, and they're coming at you and they're interested in you. Rather than telling them, I'm not interested in you, you still agree to have lunch with them, have coffee with them. And in your mind, it's like, it's only lunch and coffee, it's not a date. But if they like you, they will grasp at every single opportunity to call it a date. You can share like a piece of chocolate with them and they think it's a date. So the point here is be very, very direct when you communicate and you don't need to worry about sparing people's feelings. We're all adults here. We need to learn. And we need to not waste our each other's time and our time. So it's really important to communicate the way that you mean. And if you're dealing with a fire sign, you need to be very clear when you communicate. Otherwise, they're gonna think, the worst. And their tantrums are actually quite difficult to handle. So just a heads up. On the other end, what I'm feeling here is so they mention here spot opportunists, okay? So going off that message, people are going to show their true colors. And Mercury retrograde cycles, I used to hate it when I was younger, but what I've noticed over the years is that Mercury retrograde cycles are, it's a notorious time for information to come to light. People that have been lying, people that have been stealing, people that have been doing things kind of under the radar, they've been doing things they're not supposed to. It's going to come to light. So it's a really, really good time for karma to work itself out. And it's not always, you know, it's difficult, mainly because people that we didn't anticipate, or secrets that we didn't think would actually come out, they do come out. So everything comes out in the wash. And more importantly, you're gonna know how you feel about people, and you're gonna know where you stand with other people. Okay, you might like somebody, but if the feeling's not mutual, you're gonna know where you feel, where you stand with them. You're gonna know how, by virtue of where you stand with them, how they really feel about you. And so it's a good time overall for us to get like a little bit of that reality check. Okay? And so I don't feel that you need to worry about this. What I have here is conflict with an earth sign. So Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Somebody that is a little bit territorial, but the way that they handle conflict is they're very indirect. It's almost like, I want to say, a little bit manipulative and a little bit indirect. They want what's theirs, but rather than saying, I want this, I'm going to do this, and I think you should do that, like, you know, being direct, they're evasive, they're kind of manipulative, and they are also spinning ideas. Okay, so it's someone who's really crafty, so you want to be a little bit careful. Let me see where this is coming in. So Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. Give me one second. The way that this person's energy is showing up here, for those of you who are undergoing some type of a training, some type of a classroom teaching, some type of a seminar, or you're in a situation where you are learning something or teaching something, this is coming out. I'm also feeling this is like a disgruntled ex, somebody that you left behind, and now they're kind of resentful. They're disgruntled, they're resentful. Okay, so they're going to spin a web of lies, and you need to be careful. And then I'm also feeling as well, this is somebody that I'm seeing. I'm seeing like a business partnership, a person that they feel, you know, like they feel like they made a lot of sacrifices to help you get where you are. And then they feel like as soon as you got where you are, or where you are right now, they're no longer in the picture. And I feel like it's a natural process of falling, things falling away, or the relationship just went awry, but they didn't see it that way. So they felt betrayed. They felt left behind, or they felt cast aside. And so if that's a misunderstanding, you definitely can approach them with it, okay? But I feel like this is somebody that you're in a learning environment, a training environment, you're training them, they're training you, or you both are in some type of a training environment in order to do something. Very opportunistic. And I also want to say as well, there's hostility, there's resentment here. The last message here is spot opportunities. Okay, so this is opportunities for, especially in the work front, if there are opportunities to negotiate, definitely go for it. Spot opportunities when it comes to your housing situation. I'm sensing they're saying like two houses. So I don't know if you own multiple properties, or you are torn between should I buy this house or that house? Should I rent this one or that one? Or like you're living in one place and the work is in another place, and you're like, should I move closer? Should I move? Should I stay where I am, commute, or should I move closer? I feel like the answer is somewhere in between. So it's like move closer, but don't live in that same city. That's what I'm getting here. So opportunities are going to be in abundance around you. Work is looking really, really good. Very, very good. And I'm really happy to see this for you guys because I know last year you guys were struggling a bit. And you're going to start to, make things happen, make new friends, reach out, and have a community of people at your side. Okay. So you guys are in a really good space right now where all the people that you've helped in the past, I feel like, karma is being repaid. Karma is being played out it's coming full circle. But it looks to me like it's good. Okay. So it's coming full circle. Things are going to be okay moving forward. So the struggle is over. Cancers, I feel like, you've got a really bright future ahead of you. I would also urge you be direct with your communication, okay? Don't waste other people's time, don't send mixed messages. And the way we communicate sets the energy, the tone, and the intentions to allow the right things to come into our lives. And I feel last year you guys were very muddled, mainly because you're not very clear with your communication. So just think of it, the way the things that we say energetically dictates what we don't want and what we want in our lives. So if somebody is approaching you and they're like smitten by you and you have no interest in them, you need to tell them, I'm not interested in you. That allows them to energetically leave your space so that you can make room for the right people to come into your life. And then on the other hand, if you're with somebody that you're not in love with and you're telling them, I love you, and all of that, it's false promises, false intentions, false energy, and it can really bog you down. So learning from 2016, if you're not feeling it, kind of push it away, okay? Just like with your thoughts, with your words, with your intention, push it away, deny it entry so that you can leave that vacuum for something better to come in. Being very direct and very concise and very honest with our communication, I feel, is really going to help you guys, okay? So you're in a good space right now. You want to maintain it. So be clear and unclouded with your intentions. I'm going to leave it at that. Cancers, I wish you all the best, okay? I might or might not have time for the mid-month reading. If I don't, I'll see you guys in May, okay? Take care of yourself. I wish you all the best and have a blessed rest of April 2018. Bye-bye.